All right, take a seat, because this is going to be a longer one than usual, because in March a lot happened. So the first thing we're covering today is the new commenting feature. You might have seen it. I noticed that this was missing as soon as I started working in Evernote. I remember thinking, God, I wish I could leave comments on the shared notes. We all use Evernote, many of us, for work, and we share notes between each other. And I really, really wanted this. I wasn't alone, but at the same time, there was stuff that was more pressing for our users. So I'm very happy that now it was the time to build it. How does it work? You can just highlight a portion of text, a paragraph, a few words. You can press comment and you can write comment on that section. Your name will appear before it, and you will also be able to see the conversation of other people commenting on the same thread. And of course, you will be able to click the icon comment to add one to a new section. You will be able to reply existing ones and to edit and delete via the three dots menu that you see in the top right. Next is four new customization improvements. So during March, we focused a lot on all the customization stuff that you've been asking for. And I'm very happy that this basically demonstrates how closely we hear feedback from the community. So the first one is customize your daily note template. When we released the daily note feature, many customers were happy because they've been asking it for a while. Many were also happy, but they were like, yeah, it's so close to what I actually needed. I just need a bit of more customization. And here it is. So now in your settings, you will be able to choose a custom template for the daily note feature. And it will be used to create all of your subsequent daily notes. And then there's the ability to customize the template shortcuts in the note editor. So when you create a new note, you have a list of templates that you can choose to click to start from those templates. Of course, in case you don't have any, you can create one from there. But generally what happens is if you create on the My Templates button, you will see this section where you can just choose which ones you want to see there and to pin, basically. And when you click select, you will see them in the new notes so that you can basically press those to fill the new note with that template. Another thing that many people were asking for is the ability to hide the slash comments menu and the at menu. You can now in the settings hide them so that by hitting slash or hitting at, you will not trigger them anymore. On mobile, you can now have widgets. When we built the new mobile navigation, we moved away from the widgets. It was previously created the homepage, but it's actually a list of widgets. We moved away from it because it was making the app launch very slow. So we moved to the new create section and then we built customizability. But we do hear feedback from some of our customers saying, I really, really like that. I don't care if it's slower. I want my widgets. You can now have those widgets in navbar. And of course, you can have them as the default launch page. So in the settings, you will be able to see the widgets page as a potential homepage, like the landing page when you open the app. And you can also now sync your navigation options between devices. So let's say you have more than one computer where you have Evernote installed, or maybe you use the app and also the web app sometimes. Basically now the settings will sync across devices. It's also useful when we set up a new device, you won't have to re-customize Evernote app. Same thing for mobile, you will not need to do it. And then there's improvements to the note editor. So the first one is updated PDF and image editing tool. Basically, there's a new design and a better UX for annotating PDFs and images. It was pretty dated and now it's pretty cool instead. But if you use it, you know that it could use a fresh coat of paint. You have now more control over the font size on the note editor. Previously, you needed to select an item from the drop-down menu. Now you can actually decide manually the numbers, so just like writing numbers with your keyboard, so you have more granularity over font size, basically. You also have a sleeker image toolbar. So this was the previous way it looked. Basically two toolbars, one above it, one containing the name, the size, and the transcribe button. Now everything is merged into this section here with a three-dot menu that you can use to select more. And there's also an update to the AI transcribe web tool, so the video to text via URL. Now you can go on evernote.com/AI transcribe and hit transcribe video link and paste there the link of a video, and you will get the transcription from that video in the same page. And now a couple of things that are coming soon, which are pretty exciting. The first one is you will be able to choose the default font settings. So for both for normal text and for headers, you will be able to customize the font, the color, and the size so that all your notes or all your new notes will have those applied. This will not change the old ones. This will just set the standard for the ones that you create from now on. So pretty cool. And then request access to a note. When sharing a note, sometimes the sender doesn't perfectly set up the sharing settings. And so now when you land on a note for which you don't have access, you can just press request access. The owner will receive a notification and they will be able to review the request. If the review is approved, you will get access to the note. And that's it. Thank you so much. This was a longer one. I'm super proud of how much stuff the team is working on. And yeah, I'll see you soon.